Dear learners, once again, I, Chainika Senapati, welcome you all to the part 2 of the video on the Unit 3, that is Functions of Management of Principles of Management and Organization Behavior course from first semester BBA program of Krishnakanta Hendi State Open University. In the last part, that is part 1 of the Unit 3, that is the Functions of Management, what we have learned is the functions like planning, organizing and staffing. So today we will discuss briefly about the other functions of management like directing, controlling, and also we'll discuss about budgeting and reporting. So let's start with the video, and I will discuss this video with a PPT for your better understanding. So dear learners, what we are going to discuss in this video session is that we'll learn about directing, we'll know about the concept of directing, we'll discuss about controlling and its types, then we'll discuss about coordination and its features or characteristic, and after that we'll discuss briefly about budgeting and reporting. So we know that planning is very important in an organization. Planning is the first and the primary function of management. So let's say in an organization, planning is done, then the activities which should be taken may be systematically organized, organization is well planned, then the staffs are who are performing the tasks, the staffs are very highly qualified and they are efficient and effective, but the organization may not succeed in its to achieve the goal of the organization if there is no proper direction. So mere planning, organizing and staffing that we discussed in the earlier video, the part one of the video, are not sufficient to set the task in motion. So when we talk about directing involves not only instructing people what to do, but also ensuring that they know what is expected from them. So directing is a process in which the manager instruct, guide and oversee the performance of the workers to achieve predetermined goals. Planning, organizing, staffing has got no importance if direction function does not take place properly. So here I would like to mention about the characteristics of direction. Here we can say that direction, it is a pervasive function. Like directing is required at all levels of management, may it the top, middle or the low level of management. It is a continuous activity. Direction is continuous activity as it continues throughout the life of the organization. Then human factor. Since human resource is complex and behavior is unpredictable, direction function becomes more important in this regard. Then the creative activity, direction function helps in converting plans into performance, so it needs creative activity. And executive function, last characteristic is the executive function that I am mentioning here in this video, that all manager and executives at all levels throughout the working of an enterprise carry out direction function. So let us now discuss about controlling. So controlling is measuring and correcting individual or organizational performance to ensure that effective events conform to plans. It involves measuring performance against set goals and plans, showing where deviations from the standard exist and helping to correct those deviations. The control process is cyclical, which means it is never ending. So I would like to mention here that there is a relationship between planning and controlling. Planning and controlling are closely related and reinforce each other. Once a plan becomes operational, controlling is necessary to monitor the progress, and then measure it, then discover the deviations, and initiative should be taken for corrective measures to ensure that the events conforms the plans. So planning based on the fact makes controlling easier and effective, and controlling improves future planning by providing information derived from the past experience. So planning and controlling both are very much interrelated. So controlling is measuring and correcting individual or organizational performance to ensure that event conform to plans. It involves measuring performance against set goals and plans, showing where deviations from the standards exist and helping to correct those deviations. So I have given a definition by Koontz and O'Donnell. It is like that: as the measurement and correction of the performance of activities of subordinates in order to make sure that enterprise objectives and plans devised to attain them are being accomplished. So this is a definition given by Koontz O'Donnell on controlling. Now there are some of the sub-function of controlling. So first is the determination of standards for measuring work performance, then measurement of actual performance, then comparing the actual performance with the standard set, and finding out the variations between the two and the reasons for variations. So these are the sub-functions of controlling. And also I'd like to mention here that controlling is very important because it accomplishes the organizational goals. It is important in judging the accuracy of the standard set. Then it is important for making efficient use of resources. It improves employee motivation it ensures order and discipline in the organization, and it facilitates coordination in action. So controlling is very important. So here is the control process. And control process is cyclical in nature, which means it is never ending. And controlling is a four-step process of establishing performance standards based on the firm's objective, then measuring and reporting actual performance, then comparing the two, and taking corrective or preventive actions as and when necessary. So these are the four-step process of controlling that I have mentioned here in this video session. Now let us discuss about coordination. So in every organization, different types of work are performed by various groups, and it becomes essential that the activities of the different work groups and the departments should be harmonized. So this function is in management is known as coordination. So coordination is the orderly arrangement of individual or group efforts to provide unity of action in the pursuit of a common goal. So here I have mentioned that the coordination function of management is the harmonious blending of the activities of the different specialists and also of the different departments for the achievement of the desired goal. And this is called coordination. So here also I have mentioned about the features or characteristics of coordination. Coordination is the orderly arrangement of the group efforts. It provides unity of action in pursuit of common purpose that I have already said. And unity of action is considered to be the heart of the coordination process, of course. And it aims at achieving the common purpose of the enterprise through the orderly synchronization of the efforts of the subordinates. It is a process whereby an executive develops an orderly pattern of group efforts for accomplishing the common objective of the enterprise, and the task of coordination is a managerial responsibility, and coordination can be made effective only if an executive makes conscious effort, and of course it is a continuous process. So now that we have discussed about coordination, let us briefly discuss about the last two concepts, or you may can say the functions of management is that of budgeting and reporting. So time and money are a scarce resource to all individual and organization. The efficient and effective use of these resources requires planning. So planning is very important in this regard. Planning is the first, as I have said, first function of management, and it is important at every level of management also. So planning alone, however, is insufficient. So control is also necessary to ensure that the plans actually are carried out. So a budget is a tool that managers use to plan and control the use of the scarce resource. And a budget is a plan showing the company's objective and how management intends to acquire and use resources to attain those objectives. So by a budget, we can say that a budget shows management's operating plans for the coming periods. It formalizes management's plans in a quantitative term. It forces all levels of management to think ahead, anticipate the results, and take actions to remedy possible for poor results. And lastly, it may motivate individuals to strive to achieve stated goals. So here I have stated some of the conditions of budget. So here the budgeting involves the coordination of financial and non-financial planning to satisfy organization goal and objective, and budget makers should carefully consider the conditions that follow: top management support, participation in goal setting, then communicating results, then flexibility, then follow-up. So lastly, let us discuss about reporting. So reporting is a process of providing information to various levels of management so as to enable in judging the effectiveness of their responsibility centers and become a base of taking corrective measures if necessary in the organization. So dear learners, we have come to the end of today's video session, that is part 2 of unit 3, functions of management. So what we have gone through in this video is that we discuss about directing, we discuss about controlling, coordination, and lastly we discuss about budgeting and reporting. So all the functions of management we have discussed in the previous session and also in this video session are very closely interrelated. However, these functions are highly indistinguishable and virtually unrecognizable on the job. So it is necessary though to put each function separately into focus and deal with it separately. So dear learners, I have briefly touched up about the functions of management in the earlier video session and also in this session. In the next session, we will discuss about the managerial skills and the styles, and hope with this video session you have learned about the functions of management. Thank you.